Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Esteem's Tech, and in today's tutorial we are going to learn about variables. It is clear that Python is a great calculator. If you want to do more complex calculations though, you will want to save values while you are coding along. You can do this by defining a variable, and variables are specific and case sensitive names. Call up value through variable name. So we can also call up any value through variable name. So let's start how we can do it. Like we did it here, as you can see, A is a variable, B is a variable, and all C, D, E, F, G, H, these all are variables. So now if I want to do something like, see, A is 56 and I'm printing here, I'm just typing here A and I'm clicking on run. See, now I can print the value of this variable A. Okay, so now if I'm typing here B is 67 and I'm typing B here, it is giving me the, it is printing the value of B only but not A. So it means only one item can be printed, like the last one, like B can be printed but not A. So if you want to print both the values, in that case this print statement came into existence. So that is why we require print statement to print all the values. So now we have an activity. Let's go to the next slide. The activity is like, suppose you have $100 which you can invest with a 10% return each year. After 1 year, it's 100 into 1.1, that is $110, right? And after two years, it is 100 into 1.1 into 1.1, right, equals to $121. And up with after 7 years and print the result. And we have given the hint as well, use asterisk and double asterisk symbol, like we have to multiply and we have to use the exponentiation operator. Alright, so also another hint is also given here, create a variable growth multiplier equal to 1.1. let's go to this. I have amount equals to 100 and now I have growth multiplier. This is growth multiplier, sorry, this is growth multiplier variable, which is 1.1. okay, now go to the slide. Create a variable result equal to the amount of money you saved after 7 years. Result, this is another variable result, and in here I have to put 100, no, it should be amount into growth multiplier double into 7, right? So we want amount with us after 7 years, so we have to do like this, and after that we have to print the result. See, now run. So this is the amount that you'll be having after 7 years. Okay, and if I want to print something like, after 2 years, after 2 years amount will be 100 into 1.1 into 2, and if I want to print it as well, after 2 years. After 2 years, it is this. Alright. So after 7 years, the amount will be this. I hope you got it. So our next activity is, suppose you measure your height and weight in metric units. You are 1.79 meters tall and 68 you and weigh 68.7 kilograms, right? So let's take two variables, height and weight. I'm going to create another cell. Height and weight, two variables. And height is 1.79. Oops, sorry. It's 1.79. Okay, now 68.7 is your weight. Okay, so now in the activity, you can assign these values to two variables named height and weight. This we have done with an equal sign, right? If you now type the name of the variable height, Python looks for a variable name, retrieves its value and prints it out. So we want to retrieve the value of height and print it. So how we can do it? It's so simple. Print, type height and run. So this is height. It has retrieved the value of height and it has printed it for us. This is the activity. So simple. So next activity is, you have height 1.7 meter and weight 65 kg. Height 1.7 and weight 65. Okay. Right. So now calculate BMI, and yeah, this hint is given, weight divided by height square. BMI equals to weight divided by height, double asterisk to, and then print BMI. BMI is body mass index. See, so this is the body mass index. How simple? So simple it is, right?